It's funny because a language almost plays like a music in and of itself. The oral experience of hearing the movie with the amazing music of Sufjan, with Timmy playing the piano beautifully, with all the languages drifting in and out, it's really a treat.
There's a whole bit where I'm playing Bach and I play the variations on Bach with Liszt and Busoni, and Ermi comes in. The sort of seduction plays out by the way of piano playing, and that's why I was out in Italy a month and a half to learn those piano pieces, so when it came time to doing it, it felt like, all right, it's all or nothing now.
I just played it the way Busoni would have played it if he'd altered Liszt's version.
And what is wrong with Bach, the way Bach would have played
Bach's
version?
Bach never wrote it for the guitar. In fact, we're not even sure Bach wrote
Forget
it at all.
Forget I asked.
The stuff with the piano plays on one long shot, so the experience of doing it was anxious because, you know, the further you progress in a take, that's in one shot, there's a little voice in the back of your head that starts to go, oh God, this is going well, like, don't screw it up, don't screw it up. But then there's a great gift in it too, because the relationship, particularly towards the beginning between Oliver and Ellie, was very much a game of seduction and a physical dialogue, and to be able to express a playfulness or a sense of coyness through song is... it's rare.
It's young Bach. He dedicated it to his brother.